Good morning, brothers and sisters. Welcome to the Minor Basilica of Our Lady of the Holy Rosary of Manawa. We will now pray the Holy Rosary. Please kneel.
O sacred feast, in which we partake of Christ, his sufferings are remembered. Our minds are filled with his grace, and we receive the pledge of the glory which is to be ours. You gave them bread from heaven to be their food.
And this bread contained all goodness.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, you gave us the Eucharist as a memorial of your suffering and death. May your worship of this sacrament of your body and blood help us to experience the salvation you want for us, and the peace of the kingdom where we live with the Father and the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Queen of heaven, rejoice, alleluia.
For he whom you did merit to bear, alleluia.
Has risen as he said, alleluia.
Pray for us to God, alleluia.
Rejoice and be glad, O Virgin Mary, alleluia.
For the Lord has truly risen, alleluia.
Let us pray. O God, who gave joy to the world through the resurrection of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, grant, we beseech you, that through the intercession of the Virgin Mary, his mother, we may obtain the joys of everlasting life. Through the same Christ, our Lord. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you.
Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Lord, open my lips,
and my mouth shall declare your praise.
God, come to my assistance.
Lord, make haste to help me.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
The Luminous Mysteries. The first luminous mystery is the baptism of the Lord. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
The second luminous mystery is the wedding at Cana.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The third luminous mystery is the proclamation of the kingdom of God. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
The fourth luminous mystery is the Transfiguration.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The fifth luminous mystery is the institution of the Holy Eucharist. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
We fly to your patronage, O Holy Mother of God. Despise not our petitions and our necessities, but deliver us from all dangers, O ever-glorious and blessed Virgin. Queen of the Holy Rosary of Manawag, pray for us.
That we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. O God, whose only begotten Son, by his life, death, and resurrection, has purchased for us the rewards of eternal life, grant, we beseech you, that meditating upon these mysteries of the Holy Rosary of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we may imitate what they contain and obtain what they promise, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Prayer to Saint Joseph. Behold the faithful and prudent steward,
whom the Lord has set over his household.
The Lord has shown him his love and covered him with glory.
He has clothed him in splendid garment.
Let us pray. Father, you entrusted our Savior to the care of Saint Joseph. By the help of his prayers, may your church continue to serve her Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. Prayer for Dominican vocations. Lord Jesus Christ, your love for Saint Dominic inspires us now to implore your help and seek your intercession for all the Dominicans in the Philippines and the whole world. In confidence, we ask you to strengthen them with the virtues of chastity, poverty, and obedience, that they may live with one mind and heart. Lead to the order men and women willing to live and preach the truth of the gospel after the example of Saint Dominic, and mercifully grant that we may all be moved with a zeal for your glory in saving souls and become partakers of your crown in heaven. Amen. Saint Dominic de Guzman,
pray for us.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. Welcome to the Minor Basilica of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manawag. Today is Thursday of the third week of Lent. We will now have the morning prayer of the Church to be followed by the celebration of the Holy Mass. We invite you to please actively participate in our prayers. Please stand.
Lord, open my lips,
and my mouth shall declare your praise.
The Lord is risen. Alleluia.
The Lord is risen. Alleluia.
Come, let us sing to the Lord, and shout with joy to the rock who saves us. Let us approach him with praise and thanksgiving, and sing joyful songs to the Lord.
The Lord is risen. Alleluia.
The Lord is God, the mighty God, the great King over all the gods. He holds in his hands the depths of the earth and the highest mountains as well. He made the sea, it belongs to him, the dry land too, for it was formed by his hands.
The Lord is risen. Alleluia.
Come then, let us bow down and worship, bending the knee before the Lord our Maker, for he is our God and we are his people, the flock he shepherds.
The Lord is risen. Alleluia.
Today listen to the voice of the Lord. Do not grow stubborn as your fathers did in the wilderness, when at Meribah and Massah they challenged me and provoked me, although they had seen all of my works.
The Lord is risen. Alleluia.
40 years I endured that generation. I said, they are a people whose hearts go astray, and they do not know my ways. So I swore in my anger, they shall not enter into my rest.
The Lord is risen. Alleluia.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
The Lord is risen. Alleluia.
Seated.
City of God, you are the source of our life. With music and dance, we shall rejoice in you. Alleluia. On the holy mountain is his city, cherished by the Lord. The Lord prefers the gates of Zion to all Jacob's dwellings. Of you are told glorious things, O city of God.
Babylon and Egypt I will come. Among those who know me, Philistia, Tyre, Ethiopia, these will be her children, and Zion shall be called mother, for all shall be her children.
It is he, the Lord, the Most High, who gives each his place. In his register of peoples he writes, these are her children, and while they dance they will sing, in you all find their home.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Like a shepherd, he will gather the lambs in his arms and carry them close into his heart. Alleluia. Here comes with power the Lord God, who rules by his strong arm. He is his reward with him, his recompense before him.
Like a shepherd, he feeds his flock. In his arms, he gathers the lambs, carrying them in his bosom, and leading the ewes with care.
who has cupped in his hand the waters of the sea and marked off the heavens with a span, who has held in a measure the dust of the earth, weighed the mountains in scales and the hills in a balance,
who has directed the Spirit of the Lord or has instructed him as his counselor, whom did he consult to gain wisdom, to gain knowledge, who taught him the path of judgment, or showed him the way of understanding?
Behold, the nations count as a drop of the bucket, as rust on the scales. The coastlands weigh no more than powder.
Lebanon would not suffice for fuel, nor its animals be enough for holocausts. Before him all the nations are as naught, as nothing and void he accounts them.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Great is the Lord in Zion. He is exalted above all the peoples. Alleluia. The Lord is King, the peoples tremble. He is thrown on the cherubim, the earth quakes. The Lord is great in Zion.
He is supreme over all the peoples. Let them praise his name, so terrible and great. He is holy, full of power.
You are a king who loves what is right. You have established equity, justice, and right. You have established them in Jacob.
Exalt the Lord our God. Bow down before Zion his footstool. He, the Lord, is holy.
Among his priests were Aaron and Moses. Among those who invoke his name was Samuel. They invoked the Lord, and he answered.
To them he spoke in the pillar of cloud. They did his will, they kept the law, which he, the Lord, had given.
O Lord our God, you answered them. For them you were a God who forgives, yet you punish all their offenses.
Exalt the Lord our God. Bow down before his holy mountain, for the Lord our God is holy.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
If Christ is in you, the body is dead because of sin, while the Spirit lives because of justice. If the Spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, then he who raised Jesus from the dead will bring your mortal bodies to life also, through his Spirit dwelling in you.
The Lord is risen from the tomb. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord is risen from the tomb. Alleluia, alleluia.
He hung upon the cross for us.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
The Lord is risen from the tomb. Alleluia, alleluia.
Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever believes in me will live forever. Alleluia. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people and set them free.
He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of his servant David.
Through his holy prophets he promised of old that he would save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us.
He promised to show mercy to our fathers and to remember his holy covenant.
This was the oath he swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight, all the days of our life.
You my child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins.
In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever believes in me will live forever. Alleluia.
Christ rose from the dead and is always present in his church. Let us adore him and say,
stay with us, Lord.
Lord Jesus, victor over sin and death, glorious and immortal, be always in our midst, we pray.
Stay with us, Lord.
Come to us in the power of your victory, and show our hearts the loving kindness of the Father, we pray.
Stay with us, Lord.
Come to heal a world wounded by division, for you alone can transform our hearts and make them one, we pray.
Stay with us, Lord.
Strengthen our faith in final victory, and renew our hope in your second coming, we pray.
Stay with us, Lord. Let us now pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Let us pray. Father, in this holy season, we come to know the full depth of your love. You have freed us from the darkness of error and sin. Help us to cling to your truths with fidelity. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, let us feel your compassion more readily during these days when by your gift we have known it more fully, so that those you have freed from the darkness of error may cling more firmly to the teachings of your truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The angel of the Lord spoke to Philip, "Get up and head south on the road that goes down from Jerusalem to Gaza, the desert route." So he got up and set out. Now there was an Ethiopian eunuch, a court official of the Candace, that is, the queen of the Ethiopians, in charge of her entire treasury, who had come to Jerusalem to worship and was returning home. Seated in his chariot, he was reading the prophet Isaiah. The Spirit said to Philip, "Go, and join up with a chariot. Philip ran up and heard him reading Isaiah the prophet and said, "Do you understand what you are reading?" He replied, "How can I, unless someone instructs me?" So he invited Philip to get in and seat with him. This was the scripture passage he was reading. Like a sheep, he was led to the slaughter, and as a lamb before its shearer is silent, so he opened not his mouth. In his humiliation, justice was denied him. Who will tell of his prosperity? For his life is taken from the earth. Then the eunuch said to Philip in reply, "I beg you, about whom is the prophet saying this? About himself or about someone else?" Then Philip opened his mouth, and beginning with the scripture passage, he proclaimed Jesus to him. As they traveled along the road, they came to some water, and the eunuch said, "Look, there is water. What is to prevent my being baptized?" Then he ordered the chariot to stop, and Philip and the eunuch both went down into the water, and he baptized him. When they came out of the water, the Spirit of the Lord snatched Philip away, and the eunuch saw him no more, but continued on his way, rejoicing. Philip came to Azotus and went about proclaiming the good news to all the towns until he reached Caesarea. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Bless our God, you peoples. Loudly sound his praise. He has given life to our souls and does not let our feet slip.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Hear now, all you who fear God, while I declare what he has done for me. When I appealed to him in words, praise was on the tip of my tongue.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Blessed be God who refused me not my prayer or his kindness.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy. Please stand.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
I am the living bread that came down from heaven, says the Lord. Whoever eats this bread will live forever.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the crowds, "No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draw him, and I will raise him on the last day. It is written in the prophets, they shall all be taught by God. Everyone who listens to my Father and learns from him comes to me. Not that anyone has seen the Father except the one who is from God. He has seen the Father. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever believes has eternal life. I am the bread of life. Your ancestors ate the manna in the desert, but they died. This is the bread that comes down from heaven, so that one may eat it and not die. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever. And the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Sa atin pong ebanghelyo, natunghayan po natin yung bahagi ng tinatawag na Bread of Life Discourse. Actually, mahaba po ito. Isang bahagi lamang po ito. Ito po yung tinatawag na Bread of Life Discourse. At ito po ang pinakamahalagang katotohanan ng ating pananampalataya. Bakit? Ano ba ang sinasabi ng ating Panginoon dito? Sinasabi niya na siya ang tinapay ng buhay. Sinasabi niya na siya ang tinapay na nagmumula pa sa langit na bumaba dito sa lupa. Siya ang tinapay na nagbibigay ng buhay na walang hanggan. Sa katunayan nga po, ikinumpara pa ng ating Panginoon ang kanyang pagliligtas sa pagliligtas na ginawa ng Diyos noong panahon ni Moises. Dahil nga po sabi ng ating Panginoon dito, "Your ancestors ate manna in the desert, but they died. This is the bread that comes down from heaven." Ano ba yung kinukumpara ng ating Panginoon dito? Ito po yung pagliligtas na nangyari sa Book of Exodus o yung Exodus. Dahil nga po nung panahon ni Moises, ang mga Israelita, ang mga tao ng lumang tipan, ay iniligtas po mula sa pagkaalipin sa Ehipto. At ang pagliligtas po ng ating Panginoon ay hindi po natatapos sa kanilang pagliligtas mula sa Ehipto dahil sila po ay dadalin sa lupang pangako. Ganyan po yung kumpletong kwento ng pagliligtas ng ating Panginoon. Pagliligtas mula sa Ehipto at ang kanilang paglalakbay hanggang sa makarating sila sa lupang pangako. At sila po ay naglakad sa disyerto at sila ay pinakain ng ating Panginoong Diyos ng mana. Pinakain po sila ng parang tinapay. Dahil po ang kanilang paglalakbay ay tumagal ng 40 taon, sila po ay pinakain po sa disyerto dahil sila ay nasa disyerto. Ito po yung unang pagliligtas na kinukwento ng ating Panginoon. Ang totoo po niyan, nakarating naman yung mga Israelita sa lupang pangako. Sila ay nakarating sa kanilang destinasyon, kaya lang sabi nga ng ating Panginoon, sila ay namatay. Sapagkat ang sinasabi ng ating Panginoon na ang kanyang pagliligtas ay hindi lamang pisikal na pagliligtas. Dahil po sa lumang tipan, ang mga Israelita, iniligtas mula sa Ehipto hanggang sa makarating sila sa lupang pangako, tayo naman po, tayo mga tao ng bagong tipan ay iniligtas ng ating Panginoon mula saan? Mula sa kaligtasan, mula sa kasalanan. At ganoon din po, tayo ay may destinasyon. Kung sila po, mula sila sa Ehipto hanggang sa lupang pangako, tayo po, iniligtas tayo ng ating Panginoon mula sa kasalanan at ang ating destinasyon ay ang ating tunay na tahanan sa langit. Yan po ang gustong-gustong sabihin sa atin na ating Panginoon. Kaya po siya bumaba dito sa lupa, ibinibigay yung kanyang katawan bilang ating pagkain. Isang magandang tanong po siguro dito is sapagkat tayo nga po ay naniniwala naman sa sinasabi ng ating Panginoon dito na tayo ay tumatanggap ng kanyang katawan sa banal na Eukaristiya, katawan ni Kristo. Pero ang tanong po, kung talagang tinatanggap natin yung katawan ni Kristo, anong bahagi kaya ng katawan ni Kristo ang tinatanggap natin? Kung tinatanggap natin ng ating Panginoon sa Eukaristiya, anong bahagi kaya ng kanyang katawan ang tinatanggap natin? Ano sa tingin niyo po? Diba, tinatanggap natin yan sa komunyon, katawan ni Kristo. Pero sa tingin niyo, ano kayang bahagi ng katawan ni Kristo yung tinatanggap natin? Alam niyo po, sa ating panahon ngayon, napaka mapalad tayo sapagkat meron na po tayong siyensya, meron na tayong medisina. Yan pong katanungan na yan ay nasasagot na po sa panahong ito. Kasi alam niyo po, sa kasaysayan ng ating simbahan, marami pong mga Eucharistic miracles. mga ostya o mga ostyang abo na nagkaroon ng himala. Sa buong mundo po, sa kasaysayan ng ating simbahan, meron pong mga 100 plus, mahigit 100 na Eucharistic miracles. Ano ba yung mga Eucharistic miracles na to? Yung nga pong ostya na nagiging laman o kaya nagiging dugo. O yung kalis, yung alak na nagiging dugo. Marami po yan. Kung isa-search po natin sa internet, napakaswerto nga po natin sa panahon ngayon, search lang po natin sa internet o kaya sa YouTube, makikita na po natin dito. Isang magandang halimbawa po nito is yung himala po na nangyari po sa Argentina, sa Buenos Aires, noong 1990s. Magkukwento lang po ako na isa. Kasi nga po, sasagutin natin yung tanong na kung talagang yung osya ay katawan ni Kristo, anong bahagi kaya ng katawan niya ito? Isang halimbawa lang po na ibibigay ko dito yung nangyari po sa Buenos Aires nga. Dahil po nung panahon ngayon, nung 1990s, meron po kasing isang tao na nakakita ng ostya na nakapatong sa isang kandelaria doon sa simbahan nila doon sa Argentina. Ngayon po, binigay po ito sa pare at dahil nga po hindi nila alam kung ano yung ginawa doon sa ostya na yon, pag po kasi halimbawa po, nagpapakomunyon tayo dito, di ba? Minsan minalagdag na ostya, usually po kasi pwede po niya i-consume na kasi nakita naman ng tao kung ano yung nangyari. Pero po pag halimbawa, hindi natin alam kung ano yung nangyari dun sa ostya na yun, ang procedure po niyan, ilalagay po yan sa isang mangkok na tubig hanggang sa mag-dissolve po siya. Pag nag-dissolve na po siya, saka po siya i-dispose po dun sa ating sacrarium, dun po sa ating labalo, sagradong lababo, dun po sa ating sacristy. Ganon po yun. Kasi hindi natin alam kung anong ginawa sa ostya ngayon, hindi natin pwedeng i-consume. Kaya po yun, ilalagay sa mangkok ng tubig hanggang sa matunaw para yun po ay ma-dispose dun sa ating sagradong lababo. Pero po, ano nangyari ba dun sa ostya na nilagay sa tubig? Nagulat po sila, matapos ang isang linggo, yung osya ay hindi nag-dissolve. Ang katunayan po niyan, yung osya po ay naging dugo. Nagkaroon ng dugo. Kaya ito nga po yung tinatawag nating Eucharistic miracles. Kaya ano po ang ginawa nila? Noong panahon po na yun, ang obispo po ay si Pope Francis pa, si Bishop George Jorge Bergoglio, yung po ang kanyang pangalan noon. Ang naging decision po nila noon ay hindi i-publicize yung Eucharistic miracle na to. Hindi po nila pinamalita. Ito po ay nanatiling talagang walang media hanggang sa matapos po ang ilang taon, noong 2000s, pinatesting na po nila ito. At alam niyo po, para ito po ay malaman kung anong bahagi ng katawan, noong una po tinetesting nila, hindi po malaman kung anong bahagi. Hanggang sa na-discover po nila na yung po palang ostya na yon na nagkaroon ng laman at ng dugo, ang na-testing po nila ay heart tissue. Heart tissue. Kaya po alam niyo po, sa ating komunyon, banal na komunyon, ang tinatanggap po pala natin ay ang puso ng ating Panginoong Hesukristo. Ang puso ng ating Panginoon Hesukristo. At yan po yung makikita natin sa mga tests. Dahil po marami sa mga Eucharistic miracles ay tinesting na po. At pare-pareho ang nagiging resulta. Na ang banal na komunyon, na naghimala, na naging laman at naging dugo, ito po pala yung puso ng ating Panginoong Hesukristo. At isang nag-test po niyan, doon po sa miracle po sa Argentina, ay mula po sa isang doktor sa New York. Isa pong kilalang-kilalang espesyalista, si Dr. Zagabe. Ito pong si Dr. Zagabe, dalawa po yung kanyang specialization. Isa po siyang pathologist, sa isa po siyang cardiologist. Sikat po siya. Sikat na sikat po siya. Makikita po natin yan sa internet. Pathologist, bakit ba pathologist? Ang pathologist po kasi, sila po yung nag-aaral o nagtetesting po ng mga tissue na galing sa tao. Mas lalo na po yung mga namatay na. At dahil nga po sa cardiologist, mas eksperte po siya kung ano po talaga yung uri ng tissue na nakita doon sa miracle na ito. At alam niyo po na na-discover po na ito po ay heart tissue, hindi lamang po yan. Na-discover po ni Dr. Zagabe na mayroon po palang specific na bahagi ng puso. Di ba po ang ating puso, maraming bahagi. At alam niyo po kung anong bahagi po ng puso ng ating Panginoon yung ating tinatanggap. Sa medical term po, ito po yung tinatawag na, medyo technical po eh, myocardium. Ito pong myocardium, ito po yung responsable para mag-pump ng dugo sa buong katawan. Ibig sabihin po, yung bahaging ito ng puso ng ating Panginoon, hindi lamang to sa puso, bagkos ito rin po ay nasa bahagi ng pinakamahalagang bahagi ng puso. Dahil ito po yung nagpa-pump ng dugo para makarating sa buong katawan ng tao. At alam niyo po, dahil po sa research na po mga ito, marami pa pong detalye pwede po tayong madiskubre. Marami pa po tayong pwedeng malaman. Hindi, siyempre po dahil sa oras, hindi po natin maibibigay yan. Isang magandang katanungan nga, katanungan nga po, ay kung talagang dahil nga po tinatanggap natin ang katawan ni Kristo, ang dugo ng ating Panginoon, marami rin po Eucharistic miracles ang yung nga po meron pong dugo. Ang isa pong pwede nating tanong is, ano ang blood type ng ating Panginoon? Alam niyo po ba kung anong blood type ng ating Panginoon? At yan po ay dahil sa mga Eucharistic miracles. Pati po yung blood type ng ating Panginoon ay makikita po natin dito. At yan po hindi ko na lang po sasabihin para naman po meron kayong assignment. Para po kayo ay mag-research. Dahil po marami pa po tayong pwedeng malaman dito. At kaya po natin ito pinapaliwanag dahil sabi nga po natin sa umpisa pa lang po, ito po ang pinakamahalagang katotohanan ng ating pananampalataya. Ang katotohanan na hindi lamang tayo iniligtas ng ating Panginoon. Bagkos tayo ay kanyang pinapakain ng kanyang katawan, tayo pinapakain ng kanyang pinakamahalagang bahagi ng katawan, ang kanyang puso. Bakit? Hindi lamang dahil sa mahal na mahal tayo ng ating Panginoon, bagkos ay dahil gusto niya tayong dalhin sa ating tunay na tahanan sa langit. Kaya po ang ating Panginoon mula sa langit ay bumaba dito sa lupa upang ibigay ang kanyang katawan, ang kanyang puso sa atin upang sa ating paglalakbay tayo ay makarating sa ating tunay na tahanan sa langit. Kaya lang po alam niyo mga kapatid, ito pong Bread of Life discourse na ito ay mahaba. Pero alam po, nakakalungkot yung ending nito. Nakakalungkot. Kung babasahin po natin ang buo, bakit ba? Dahil nga po paulit na sinasabi ng ating Panginoon na siya ang tinapay ng buhay, na siya ang nagbibigay ng buhay na walang hanggan. Pero ang ending po nito, marami po sa kanyang tagasunod ay hindi na sumunod sa kanya. Ayaw nilang maniwala. Yun po ang ending nito, nakakalungkot. Ang natira lamang po nung pinapaliwanag ito ng ating Panginoon ay ang kanyang mga close na disipulo, ang kanyang mga apostoles. At alam niyo mga kapatid, sa ating Panginoon, ganun din po ang nangyayari sa ating Panginoon ngayon. Hindi po ba? Napakaraming Kristiyano, napakaraming Katoliko ang bininyagan. Pero hindi nila talaga sinasabuhay yung ating pananampalataya. Ang ating Panginoon binibigay sa atin ang kanyang puso, ang kanyang katawan. Pero napakaraming tao, napakaraming Kristiyano ang hindi tumatanggap sa kanya. Hindi nagsisimba linggo-linggo. Ito rin po isang katotohanan ng ating pananampalataya na nangyayari sa ating panahon ngayon. Kaya sana po sa ating banal na misang ito, ito po ang ating pagnilayan. Ang katotohanan po na ang ating Panginoon, ang ating pagkain na nanggagaling pa sa langit. At nakakalungkot nga po, marami ang taong hindi naniniwala dito. Marami ang Katoliko, ang mga Kristiyano na hindi na nagsisimba. Kaya po sa ating banal na misa, sana po ay isama natin sa ating mga panalangin dahil alam ko po, meron tayong mga personal na intensyon. Kaya po tayo nagpunta dito sa dambana ng ating mahal na ina. Pero isama naman po natin sa ating mga panalangin. Yung ating mga mahal sa buhay o yung mga kakilala natin na sa tingin natin ay hindi nagsisimba linggo-linggo. Dahil napakaganda po nung talagang binibigay sa atin ng ating Panginoon. Hindi po ba? Binibigay niya sa atin ang kanyang katawan. Hindi lamang ang kanyang katawan, bagkos ang kanyang puso. Dahil gusto niya tayong bigyan ng buhay na walang hanggan, dahil siya ay mahal na mahal tayo. Kaya sana po sa banal na misang ito, isama po natin sa ating mga panalangin, yung mga tao pong hindi na po nagsisimba, mas lalo na kung sila'y ating mahal sa buhay. At nang sa gayon po, yung biyayang tinatanggap natin ngayon sa banal na misang ito ay hindi po manatili sa atin, bagkos ay maibahagi natin mas lalo na dun sa mga nangangailangan.
Please stand.
We turn now in prayer to God the Father, who from the generosity of His heart has sent His Son, the bread of life, for every petition we shall answer. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let the people of God, nourished by the Eucharist, may unite to persevere in lives of faith and love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That through the worthy reception of the Eucharist, we may deepen our love for one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may not fail to share our earthly bread with those in need, and so become like the self-giving Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are sick in mind and body may be strengthened by receiving the body and blood of Christ in the Eucharist. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our Pope, College of Bishops, parents, relatives, benefactors, and all those for whom He promised to pray. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions of the pilgrims and devotees of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manawag, and for our personal intentions, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead may share in the Lord's promised heavenly banquet, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty Father, guide us in our journey and help us to walk in the path of your Son, Jesus, who is the bread of life. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please stand.
Pray me, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice, have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead. Grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously. When Christ our Passover has been sacrificed, he never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the Lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Socrates our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Stand.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the feast of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass has been offered. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Palakpakan natin ang Panginoon. Panalangin po para sa ating mga may sakit. God, our Almighty Father, by your blessing, you give us strength and support in our frailty. Turn with kindness toward our sick brothers and sisters, free them from all illness, and restore them to good health. Through the intercession of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manawag, so that in the sure knowledge of your goodness, they will gratefully bless your holy name. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Prayer for the blessing of your religious articles. In memory of the mysteries of the life, death, and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, and to the honor and glory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Our Lady of the Rosary of Manawag, may these rosaries, images, candles, oil, and other religious articles be blessed and made holy. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Kristo'y sambahin.
Ave, Ave, Ave Maria. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria.
Sa lahat ng pagsubok, kami ay ingatan mo.
Ave, Ave, Ave Maria. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria. Sa ligaya ng buhay, salwalhati lumbay.